When you get to my age, you've got a lot of memories, and none are more poignant than the ones I made here. This is the Romford Snooker Club, and it's where my professional journey began.
Back in 1973, the structure of snooker was very different.
The powers that be in snooker, the WPBSA, were a committee of snooker players. And they were the people who decided if you turn professional or not. It wasn't a competition to win like Q School. Your peers, or your betters at the time, decided whether you were capable of being a professional.
Just like today's players, my dreams began at an early age. What does differ though is how their journeys began.
My dad was a big snooker fan, kind of got into it that way, and he then sort of spent his weekends taking me off around the country to play in as many junior events and give me the experience as possible. As a kid, you're just there enjoying it up until a point where you sort of get to 12, 13, 14, and everyone around you's thinking what they want to do with their life, and for me, it was play snooker.
I think I got to about 15, and I was playing all the best amateurs in Glasgow, and within about a year or 18 months, I got to a level where I was thinking I could maybe do something at this game.
My dad started running junior competitions where I think the winner used to get like $5 and a Mars bar can of Coke, something like that. That moved into competing in, you know, junior state titles. It didn't take my brother and I that long to start beating the other kids who had been playing longer than us, and we had a really dominant spell where it was always one of the Robertsons winning the junior events.
People often compare the sport now to snooker's popularity in the 80s, and some are even worried about the future of the game. But just one look at this club in the heart of London on a Saturday morning would allay all those fears. For these young kids, the future is positive. John Woods is the professional coach.
All I want you to think about, at what point are you going to go into the pack? We get kids coming in from complete beginners. We've got kids as young as 6 coming in. For the most part, it's fun and games. There's some that go on, they carry on, take it seriously, and go on, end up playing in national tournaments and going on to much bigger things.
Well, I come to this club once a week, but I practice 7 days a week, maybe 6 days, for like a few hours if I have school, and then if I don't have school, maybe 8 hours a day. I play it mostly because it's like fun and I enjoy it, but I also want to be like a top professional. My really like end goal is to become like the world champion like loads of times.
Never been more opportunity, I don't think, for juniors. I mean, the amount of junior things going on around the country now is unbelievable. There's more opportunities in snooker at the moment than there has been for many years. There's more tournaments. There's more things going on, there's more opportunities for coaches and players, and I mean, it really is a great time to be involved with snooker at the moment.
So I first hit my first cue ball here at King's Cross, and I fell in love with the game ever since. My coach, John Woods, he's been by my side since I hit my first cue ball. You know, he's given me advice, he's given me support, even through my darkest times. And yeah, he's helped me a lot, and from his club, really. Obviously, my dream is to become world champion one day, turn pro one day, and become a Triple Crown winner.
The numbers are all very encouraging. There are 44 clubs in central London alone. And in the UK, there are approximately 2,500 venues where people can play snooker, of which around 1,200 are dedicated snooker clubs.
You know, just watching it on the TV, pop black, but I just loved watching it. And my father eventually got me a 6 foot, and I was away just playing it all the time, you know. As soon as I come home from school, playing it. When I get up before school, playing it. On a little 6 footer, and just loved it.
I had to read a book when I first started playing, so I had a little table in my house, and my dad said he'd take me to a proper snooker club when I had to read this book. I think it was a Roald Dahl book, Danny the Champion of the World.
I remember playing the first time in the club, and there was a guy, an older guy, he was a coach, and he saw me and he just said, "You have to keep going because you're very talented." And we believed him. We went to a coach, and yeah, I just loved the game from the beginning. I still do now.
I think it's marvellous that the game now is worldwide. and that if a kid watches on TV, they've got a chance to play the game in lots more countries around the world and maybe make it to professional level.
Most of the tour professionals still come from England, and getting to the top is no mean feat, with around 1.6 million registered members playing in the 250 active snooker leagues. However, compare that to China, where there are over 100,000 clubs dedicated to Q sports and 10,000 to snooker alone. With an estimated 60 million participants, there's almost as many people playing the sport in China as there are living in the UK.
There is access to the World Snooker Tour from anywhere in the world for anybody. There is only actually one criteria today to breaking through and making it in this sport, and it's performance on the table.
Because so many young kids play snooker in China. Players in China, they start quite early, and I think the difference between the snooker player in China and here is that they're much more dedicated. They start young, they're practicing every day. Most of my players, like Zhao Xintong, Yan Bingtao, I knew they started like when they're 8 or 9 years old.
When I was 12 years old, I have a famous teacher. Yeah, he also teach the Ding and Tian and the Shells. We are same teacher, and he teach me when I was 12 years old. When I was 13, I played the first match.
Yan Bingtao came here when he's 15 or 16, I think. He knew he can play all the games against the best player in the world.
Breaking into the top 16 may be the ambition, but getting on tour in itself is an incredible achievement. In 2021, 182 players failed to win a Pro Tour card after competing in the Q School. Amongst the 122 tour players, 79 are British. England has the largest representation with 57, and China next on 25.
Yeah, okay. You probably got to come and live in the UK, because a lot of the qualifiers and the queues to all are over here, and it's tough if you've got to do the travelling. But once you've established yourself as a tour player, then you've got every chance.
So, how do you do it? In a usual season, there are 128 places on the professional tour, and the qualifying process aids those that reach the top half, with the top 64 maintaining their professional status. However, the WST have ensured a global representation by offering tour cards to those that manage to win their regional tours in the Americas, Oceania, and Africa. Just 14 places are on offer for those wishing to progress through Q School.
What you have today is an open structure. A snooker player today could win the World Snooker Federation Championships in April. They could then be invited to the World Snooker Championships in Sheffield. They could win that and be on the professional ranks even before qualifying school takes place.
We are now at a stage where the game is as professional as it's ever been. And to be in the top 16, you really do have to have everything, not just the temperament. You've got an extra special cue power, extra special touch, extra special ability. You've got to be super good at the game.
This is the dream, playing here in front of a packed house, a fantastic atmosphere, on a fantastic setting. It's the dream for snooker players, but it is achievable.
So if you have made it into the top 16, which comes with automatic qualification for the Crucible, then congratulations. You're one in a million.